According to Brenda Akankunda, a policy analyst, trade and investment, Seattle, Uganda, despite the 12th ministerial conference agreeing that organizations like World Food Programme buys food within Uganda as a priority, Uganda's current production capacity cannot meet both local and international demand. She says there is a need to double production capacity.
The WTO ministerial conference creates a platform, first of all, being the largest decision-making body on trade. It's a good platform that countries like Uganda, looking at the fact that we are a least developed countries, for us to be able to sit on the same negotiating table and negotiate with countries like the US, like China, I think it creates a good platform. But also looking at what issues are actually put on table for negotiation. I can give you an example, an issue to do with addressing the food security, an issue to do with putting in place our TRIPS waiver. It is a critical area that we could explore, because it ideally means that even us being least developed countries, we can still be able to benefit from such programs and initiatives. For instance, if it's with COVID, we can be able to manufacture our own vaccines.
Another platform that can make money for the country is a taxation of the digital economy. However, lack of clear infrastructure has left the playing ground not leveled, thus businesses not taxed. Meanwhile, whereas the outcomes of the 12th ministerial conference are important, experts note that they impact African countries' competitiveness, industrialization, and efforts to achieve structural transformation.
All countries that are signatory to the World Trade Organization are supposed to have domestic laws that facilitate the implementation of the guidance on regulation of trade in their countries. And I'll speak to the public health laws that we should have. And in Uganda, we have 90% of our medicines, what we call generic medicines, imports from India. And we must have a law that permits us to produce or import generic medicines as a low developing country.
These were some of the views of stakeholders during a CSO's debriefing meeting in Kampala on the outcomes of the World Trade Organization 12th Ministerial Conference that happened in June this year in Geneva, Switzerland.